Up next, we're joined by Microsoft Teams expert Daniel Hidalgo to look at the latest updates for frontline workers in Microsoft Teams, from the ease of sign-in to push-to-talk communication with Walkie Talkie and more. And beyond these experiences, if you're a manager, we'll show you new ways to manage your teams with the new MyStaff portal. And for IT, we're going to show you new policy packages, team templates to speed up configuration, as well as new options for managing shared devices in Endpoint Manager. So, Daniel, welcome to Microsoft Mechanics.
Hey, Jeremy. It's a pleasure to be on the show.
And thanks for joining us today. So, over the past several months, we've actually developed a renewed sense of appreciation, I think, for frontline workers, whether they're keeping essential services up and running or saving lives literally in the frontline in healthcare. And really, at the same time, this has also revealed a gap that exists for these essential workers in terms of access to technology that really will make it easier for them to stay connected in the course of their jobs.
Yes, this segment of the working population is notoriously underserved by digital tools. And you're right, the pandemic has exposed some very real gaps when it comes to equal access to technology. In the end, these workers are often left using their own initiative to communicate, and they end up doing so in ways that can be less secure. In fact, they typically resort to consumer applications for things like information sharing.
Right, and as part of Office and Microsoft 365, we've had various solutions available for the past few years, and most recently, that's been in Microsoft Teams.
We've been working on this for a while, and really, there's no excuse for frontline workers to be left on the sideline anymore. In fact, you can avoid people finding their own potentially risky solutions by proactively extending the Teams platform to them. And the beauty here is that Microsoft Teams can run on either personal devices or shared devices. It's integrated with your back office, and it's also secure by design. You can also configure it to meet the specific needs of your workers, such as your frontline workers, their managers, or IT. So everybody benefits, and it's a consistent experience across the board.
Right, but I think one of the key pain points here is getting frontline workers up and running on their devices. So for example, everyone might typically have a phone, but it doesn't make sense for them to use their email or the company to provide an email and onboard them really in the classic ways.
Exactly. So the steps that you might use to onboard an office worker with a new email and password isn't necessarily a good option here. And it should be easier, frankly. So what I want to do is walk you through the steps that I might take as a frontline worker on my first day on the job in a retail environment. So I've been asked to install the Microsoft Teams app from the App Store or Google Play. In advance, my company set up my Azure AD account, and my new manager has added my mobile number so that I can sign in using a one-time passcode. So I will launch Teams, and it takes me to a sign-in screen. I can simply use my phone number to sign in, and that's going to send me a text message to confirm. So once I do that, I'm in. So now I can see my assigned teams and channels, and next I'll clock in, and I'm ready to work or access any other apps and tools that I'm approved to use.
Okay, so that looked pretty easy. And you can already see all the different teams that you're a member of, as well as the capabilities that you have there in the app tray at the bottom of the screen.
That's right. So the first thing I want to do is check my shifts for today and for the upcoming week. So I will click on the one for today, and you can even see notes for this shift. It looks like there's delivery coming, and we need to add price tags on everything coming in and put all items on display. There's also a note to check out the most recent message from our CEO, Patty, and I can check that out in just a second. And if I tap here on the top right of the shift button, I can also see the manager that's on shift and others that are working with me on my team. And if I go back to the home screen, I can go into tasks and see what's assigned to me. In this case, I have quite a few tasks listed. Now let's check out that note from our CEO. So I'll go back to the home screen and open the communities icon so I can take a look at the announcement. And I can see that there's guidance for following the newly established COVID safety protocol.
Okay, but this is your first day, and I have to say you're doing pretty well so far. But what happens then maybe if you get stuck or aren't sure how to do a certain task or something and need help? What do you do then?
Great point. And that's really where the communication elements in Teams shine. If I didn't have Teams, I might ask everyone for their phone number or connect with them using a direct message service or look for someone on site. But here, since I have Teams already running, I can participate in team conversations. I can either post a message to the team, I can see all of my pinned channels, or I can directly chat with a manager who we just saw is on duty to ask a question. So I'll start a private chat and search for Adele. In my case, I have a damaged box here, and I don't want to tag it with a price because I'm not sure if a customer will want to buy it. So in the chat, I'll go ahead and say, "I found a damaged box. Not sure if I should tag this item, so please advise." And as you can see, she's replying, and it looks like she wants me to send her a picture to see how it looks. So I'll tap on the photo button in Teams on my phone, take a picture, and send it. And as you can see, she wants me to set this aside to return to the supplier. So now that I've done that and completed my task, I can navigate back to my task list, then go to task details, and mark everything in the checklist here as done.
Okay, and one more thing to mention since you're showing tasks is that beyond managers assigning tasks, there are also options for the corporate office to create task plans and publish those all the way down to the store level. So what you've shown here so far is great for chat, and sometimes I think you need to talk to somebody for more immediate response and really get resolution quickly. What can you do there?
You do. And with Teams, you can directly call anyone on your team with the app. And you can do this without needing to know their phone number, as you can see here. But sometimes you might need to reach out to an entire department because maybe you don't know who can help or who is available and on shift. And we solve for this with a new capability called Walkie Talkie by allowing you to connect to a specific channel to find the help that you need. So as you can see here, I have a few suggested channels, one for security and also one that I'm most interested in, which is on curbside pickup. In this case, I'm fulfilling an order for a customer and I need to communicate with a delivery dog for curbside pickup. This is an open channel to whoever is on shift, so I don't need to figure out who's there or look them up in Teams or call them. In fact, Jeremy, let's try this out. Let's say that you are part of a team that's working on the dock, and I'm going to try to reach you. Order for Megan Bowen is ready for pickup. Please confirm you're on it. She'll be there in a few minutes.
Okay, got it. So everything's packed up and ready. We're going to greet her once she arrives.
Perfect. And you might be used to walkie-talkies with local range. But the nice thing here is that this is built into your phone, so you don't need a secondary device. And in our particular case, it's traversing from Ecuador, where I am in now, to your location in Redmond. So that's a bit more range than the walkie-talkies you might be used to in the past.
Love it. So we've seen how you can chat now and share information, even make calls or reach channels using the walkie-talkie capabilities. And this is all built into Teams, but what else can I do to personalize the experience even more?
So I've shown some of the foundational experiences that can apply across many industries or situations. But you can also create unique apps tailored to your business needs using Power Apps. Let me show you one that we've built to do a store walkthrough prior to opening our store every morning. So here you can see that I've got an app pinned in Teams, and I'll open it. And because I'm logged into the app, it knows I'm the person doing the inspection, and it fills in the date and store location by default. Now, for each area location, I can select it. I'll stick with accessories, and I fill in whether the area is clean. I'll mark yes. It's stocked. I'll mark yes again. And then I can add a note saying that it passes inspection. Then I'll save it, and I'm ready for another area inspection. Right? And this is just a simple app where we've automated what might have been done using a clipboard in the past. But now you can save paper, time, and all of the manual processes around it.
Right. And something that we've also recently announced is the ability to build these no-code or low-code apps right from within Microsoft Teams, either in the desktop app or in the browser, with the complete Power App Studio and even the underlying data backend using Dataverse. In fact, you can check out a recent show that we did with Charles Lamana that walks through an entire Power App build start to finish at aka.ms/powerappsmechanics.
Right. So our vision here really is for Microsoft Teams to provide a simple front end that can connect to your existing enterprise apps and systems of record and hopefully make things easier for your frontline workers. For example, you can manage your workforce scheduling in your ERP system and have it show up as shifts in Teams. We have a growing ecosystem of applications to help connect leading workforce management apps, such as Kronos or Blue Yonder, directly to Teams.
Okay, so you've now shown us a few highlights for the frontline worker, but why don't we switch gears a little bit and change up roles? Is there anything else that you can do as a manager now of frontline workers?
Yes, of course. So we've covered the experiences for managing shifts on previous mechanic shows, as you can see on the screen. This enables you to assign your staff schedules and manage those aspects of staffing. But as a manager, you're probably the person people come to for help. Maybe someone on your team can't log in, or they purchased a new phone. And now instead of calling IT, you can manage a few of these basic IT-related processes. So let me show you. We've built a simplified Azure AD experience called My Staff. You can access it at mystaff.microsoft.com. And if I click into Retail Employees and select Lynn, you'll see that this lets you reset passwords and add phone numbers. So I'll add hers and save it. And as you can see, for staff with phone numbers already entered, I can edit or remove them as well.
Right. And one more thing to note here is that your Azure Active Directory administrator needs to set you up as a manager with My Staff administrative privileges in order to manage defined groups and administrative units like you just saw. This is where configuring dynamic membership rules in user groups can also save you a ton of time. So these are based on things like job title or location. So for example, anyone with retail sales in their job title, along with a matching location, can be added automatically to the frontline group that Daniel just demonstrated.
Yes, and that's a great way to save time as you add frontline workers into your directory. But Jeremy, since we're on the topic of admin controls, why don't you show us a few more new things you can do to manage frontline workers?
Let's do it. So I want to show you a couple of time savers on the Teams and also Azure AD sides and something that's brand new in my favorite area of device management for frontline workers. So first, in the Teams Admin Center, I want to show you what you can do to build out teams quickly and consistently using templates. So for example, if you have retail stores with dozens or hundreds of locations, you can build out a template that has templatized channels and apps already configured so that anyone that's tasked with building out teams for existing or new stores, they can do this in just a few clicks. And before, we showed you how easy it was to get up and running with SMS sign-in, and that's all now set up with a new authentication method in the security settings of Azure AD. There is also where you'll set up the My Staff experience that Daniel showed as a manager earlier. And then back in the Teams Admin Center, you'll probably want to assign policies to tailor frontline worker experiences. So first, with policy packages, you can configure messaging, meeting, app setup, calling, and even live event policies. And this one is an out-of-box policy for frontline workers. And if I click into the details of the messaging policies, for example, you can see the granular controls for chat experiences. Now, if I click into app setup, you can also define the pinned apps that are in the Teams navigation bar. And as you'll recall, this is what we saw earlier in the bottom of the Teams mobile app. And finally, one of the things I'm most excited about are the new Microsoft Endpoint Manager preview features that make it easier to enable management of shared devices at scale. So earlier, Daniel showed how you can bring your own device as a frontline worker and sign in at the app level using Microsoft Teams. And now you can also enroll dedicated devices in Microsoft Endpoint Manager with Azure AD shared mode automatically configured. So when setting up a device enrollment profile, you select the corporate-owned dedicated devices option, click Create New Profile, and then you just select the shared mode token type for that profile. Now, this also enables shared device sign out when a user logs out of the device. In fact, you can use our SDK so this can work even with your own custom line of business apps for Android and iOS. And you can find out more at aka.ms/msoldocs. Now, let me explain how this would work. So first, shared devices can be checked out, for example, at the beginning of a shift, and frontline workers can easily sign in using the same phone number and SMS that we showed earlier. Then they'll configure a session PIN for the duration of the shift, and then with the managed home screen, you get all of your apps, including Microsoft Teams, to choose from. Now, when the shift is over, you can also sign out of the device, as well as all browser sessions and apps too that have been signed in, or automate this process from an IT perspective using timers, so that it's ready for someone else to use in a future shift.
Yes, and like you said, this is a great option to have full flexibility over all experiences on the device, to preload Teams or whatever apps you choose to using Endpoint Manager.
So thanks so much, Janet, for the great overview today and the day in the life using Microsoft Teams as a frontline worker. But for those who are watching and want to get started, what do you recommend?
Yeah, so first, I recommend you to check out aka.ms/teams-for-frontline. For all of the frontline worker resources, from end user tips to admin setup. And as always, the best way to learn is to try it out.
And that's all the time we have for this show, but be sure to subscribe and follow Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.